I've always been fascinated with the stories of the St Kilda players that I've had something to do with throughout my time, who I never really got to play with all that much. Now, I played with halves clearly and a couple of years with Lowy and Berkey, but the plugger stories around the Saints have always been absolutely legendary. So I went back and I went right through the list of the 100 games that have been nominated, and I remembered this one. And this one has been spoken about at the football club, the legendary Tony Lockett, before he went up to Sydney. This was his last year at the Saints. He kicked an absolute bag. I think he kicked 11 for the day. He kicked a lot of them in the last quarter.
I think it was 7 in the last quarter. It was a lot.
Yeah. It was a day Caven tried to headbutt his elbow and came off second best.
So Tony Lockett got 8 weeks for that. 8 weeks back then is worth about 15 now.
So he only played 10 games for the year.
And that was you know what? It's funny you look back at it.
That's number 10. He tried to take the head off the cheer squad.
It was a great kick. Weren't they giving it to him as well?
The low top and a few words to go on with. after the siren. And then next year, he's up there. He's adopted like the favourite son.
He's a bit unlucky with the Caven one. Look, I don't think he came out with malice in his heart.
Brownie.
He didn't come out with malice in his heart. It was just a reaction.
I'd love to show you it again, just to see if you can reevaluate exactly what your thoughts are on this incident. Well, he got 8 weeks, Brownie.
Well, show it again. Look, I'm not saying he shouldn't get weeks, but
there was
a bit of self-preservation there. It was a reactionary thing. Like, he wasn't 10 metres. Like, he was still thinking, I'm going to take the mark at 5 metres out. So he'd been unlucky.
What would it be graded as now? Careless or intentional?
It's a non-football action, so I think it's probably intentional.
I think it was careless.
High impact.
I thought it was careless. Anyway, you know what, Peter Craven and disagree, and his family would as well, so don't write me a letter.
It doesn't come into Michael Christian's grid. It actually goes straight to the tribunal.
How about Betty White in the background there too, just getting stuck into Plugger after he kicked that low barrel
I don't think
through.
We'll ever see someone like Plugger.
Oh, and he was an enigma. So 17 years at St Kilda, and I've only got to meet him a few times, and one was in my first year at the Team of the Century announcement where Plugger came, and I think the other one was when Halves was inducted into the St Kilda Hall of Fame as a legend, and so he came down, and that was the day where Spud introduced him and lost it up on stage. And then the last time I saw Plugger, and it would have only been the third or fourth time I've ever met him, was at the legendary St Kilda trainer and runner in the 66 Premiership, Kenny Whiffen.
Yep.
So he drove down for Kenny's funeral at Moorabbin Town Hall, turned around and drove straight back home afterwards. But, I mean, great man. He's always had plenty of time for us. Just hasn't been one of those guys that has stayed really active in the football environment once he's moved on.